I'm going to talk you through some of the features that you'll find in the new Z9. These are going to be some of the features that are going to be really useful when it comes to low light photography for astro, but also really useful for wildlife as well. The first one is what's called Starlight View. So this really allows you to really boost the live view, and it drops the frame rate of your screen, and that allows the camera to take in more light. This just really helps when it comes to composition and just arranging your shot in low light scenes, especially with other cameras. It can be difficult in really dark situations to try and figure out where your shot is, and you might have to take a practice shot. But the Starlight View in the back of the Z9 just makes that a little bit easier. You don't have to always find the composition from a picture you've taken. You can just see it on the back of the screen. Also great if it's quite cold and you're shooting outside and you want to try and get the shot as quickly as you can, or if you've got cloud cover coming over. It just means that it's going to be one less thing for you to worry about when it comes to composition of a night sky, or just composition when it comes to a low light wildlife situation. Now, one of the things that is also really important when it comes to shooting in a low light scene is making sure that you're keeping your night vision, or you're keeping your eyes sensitive to the very little amount of light that's available. So if any of you have shot astro in the past, or if you've shot again wildlife in low light situations, you'll generally understand how important it is to keep that low light sensitivity in your eyes. It's just helping you again to spot subjects or to spot stars in the sky that might not be always obvious to you if you don't have that sensitivity. One of the things that the Z9 has is a warm display color option. So this allows you to turn your display to red. So red, really conveniently, doesn't reset that kind of sensitivity to bright light. So you can continue to have that sensitivity to be able to see the sky, see your composition, and not lose that sensitivity in your eyes because of that red light that's on your screen or on your viewfinder. You've got two options. You can either have that red displayed across everything, so it's the menu, the settings, and even the preview of the image that the camera is showing you, or you have an option where it's only applied to menu screens and it's only applied to settings on the display around the actual frame in front of you, but the live view is still holding its traditional color. This is really useful if you want to compose with a particular subject in the foreground and you don't want that subject to be red. So two options to choose from depend on the circumstances and the requirements that you have when it comes to shooting in low light situations. It might seem like a really small setting, but it's going to make a huge difference if you are shooting in low light situations and you are concerned about losing that night vision that you may have gained by getting your eyes sensitive to a low light scenario.